Carol, well, I'm going to start in a minute. My wife is getting ready to put everything here so I can read it. Okay, here we go. Hi, I'm Dr. Don Hendon. I've appeared in 36 nations on 6 continents, giving talks and seminars to tens of thousands of people, all about how to influence others, how to negotiate, body language, time management, business mistakes, guerrilla marketing, and many other topics. Here are 4 of my latest books. I've written 15 in all. These books contain the 365 powerful influence techniques I've developed over the years. People use them to get what they want from other people, like how buyers get sellers to lower their prices, and how sellers get buyers to pay more, and how to get a raise from your boss, and how to get your kids to pick up their clothes. Yes, even that. Now, here are a few of the winning tactics that my audiences have raved about. Use them and see how much more often you win big when you deal with other people. Let's start off with how to prepare. Believe it or not, you should always negotiate on an empty stomach. Why? Because when you're hungry physically, you're hungry mentally too. You just plain want more, and when you want more, you ask for more. When you ask for more, you get more, much more. And then there's distraction. Put the other person off balance. Make sudden, unexpected moves. The great samurai warrior Miyamoto Musashi said, "Put your enemy off balance. Take advantage of his rhythm when he's unsettled, and you'll always win." And now here's a couple of mind games you can play. Mind games. If you're a seller, make the buyer pursue you for a change. Why does this unexpected technique work? That's because the person with the least commitment to the relationship has the most power. Let me repeat that. The person with the least commitment to the relationship has the most power. Think about it. It's so true, isn't it? Here's mind game number 2. Use funny money, not real money. In other words, talk about percentages, not absolute numbers. Say to the buyer, "It's only 2%. When a seller tells you that, you should think, that 2% is really $5 million. That's worth negotiating about. I'm not going to fall for that old trick." And now, here are a couple of extra aggressive techniques that my audiences just love. Take first, talk later. Yes, take it first, then talk about it. And don't apologize when you do this. Let me repeat that because I think my wife was sighing, okay? And now here's a couple of And now here's a couple of extra aggressive techniques that my audiences just love. Take first, talk later. Yes, take it first, then talk about it. And don't apologize when you do this. And always remember, it's a lot easier to get him to forgive you than to get his permission in the first place. So taking it first really, really works. And next, extra aggressive, make the other person feel guilty. All of you know this works. Think about it. Who is the one person in your life who has made you feel the most guilty? Your mother, right? Me too. She's always intimidated me. God rest her soul. Now here's an endurance technique. Endurance. Nibble away. Wear out the other person. Outlast him. All you have to do is take things from the other person bit by bit, so slowly that he doesn't even notice. Yeah. Eventually you'll get everything you want. And this is my wife's favorite tactic. She uses it to get whatever she wants from me, and I pretend I don't know she's doing it. I love to pamper her. Yes, I love her that much. You can also try being subtle. Use what I call the power of powerlessness. If your position is weak, show the other person how much they have to lose by taking advantage of you. Say something like, "If I go bankrupt, you'll get nothing at all from me. Is that what you really want?" And another subtle technique is what I call creeping paralysis. It works like this. Your boss pretends not to know how to operate the photocopy machine, so you do it for him. Eventually, you end up doing it for him all the time, and that's what he wanted all along. And then there's silence. Silence is the best way to respond to a totally unacceptable request. You know, we Americans are very uncomfortable with silence. A lot of my Chinese clients have told me, all we have to do is stare at you Americans and say nothing. After a while, you give us whatever we want. And the most powerful influence technique of all is, well, what do you think it is? It's body language. Body language is so powerful, it has become my number one best-selling seminar and talk. When you know body language, you can tell what's going on in the other person's mind without him knowing you know it. And that gives you a powerful advantage. Carol, my wife's going to change stuff now, and so you can edit this out. When she puts the new cheat sheets up, I'll start talking again. Ida, now look, and try to move that. Okay, I'm going to start now, Carol. And you can use your own body language to get him to do what you want him to do without him even knowing that you're influencing him at all. And believe it or not, you can learn from a lot of things from children. I mean, say that again. I'll start again from the pause. And you can use your own body language to get the other person to do what you want him to do without him even knowing that you're influencing him at all. And believe it or not, you can learn a lot from children, too. Children are natural negotiators. They know how to wrap you around their little finger, don't they? Remember the old excuse, my dog ate my homework? Today you can delay things by saying, oh, my computer crashed and I've got to recreate all my data from scratch. Sorry. And what do you do when you're backed into a corner, usually? Do you concede? Nah, you should never concede. Instead, make tempting promises. But on the other hand, never accept a promise from the other person in return from a concession that you made. Only losers do that. And by the way, one of the topics my audiences love the most is this, the 20 do's and the 20 don'ts of making concessions. 40 in all. And what do you think the most important concession you can make is? It's this, it's simple, it's listen. Listen to the other person, listen well. Listening is the cheapest concession you can make too. And finally, there's what I call the two G spots, greed and gullibility. If the other person is greedy and gullible, then just go ahead and take advantage of him. A person who is greedy and gullible is the ultimate loser. And if you're lucky enough to deal with him, you'll become the ultimate winner. Well, before I close, I've got to say that if you deal with people in other nations a lot, you'll be interested in the most valuable information I have. I've trained people all over the world in influence, persuasion, and negotiating. 54 different continents. Excuse me, let me repeat again. Well, before I close, I've got to say that if you deal with people in other nations a lot, then you'll be interested in the most valuable information I have. I've trained people all over the world in influence, persuasion, and negotiating. 54 different nationalities. They've told me what their favorite tactics are in many different situations, like how to get the buyer to pay more, how to get a seller to lower his price, how to get more money when you sell your car, how to buy a house for a much lower price, and even sexual seduction. Sexual seduction. I'll share this information with my audiences. Here's an example. When you're asking your boss for a raise, Americans use, let's look at the record more than anything else. That's one of my 121 assertive tactics. Down in South America, what do Brazilians do to get a raise? They're not assertive. They find allies in the office and use them. That's one of my 92 defensive tactics. I also have 24 cooperative tactics, 16 submissive tactics, and 81 dirty tricks, plus 31 tactics to prepare you for an important deal-making session. And by the way, foreigners love to deal with Americans. We're too impatient. People all over the world who have attended my seminars have told me, all we have to do is keep stalling. Eventually, you Americanos will give me anything I want. Well, I look forward to telling you a lot more about how to influence others and win big. in the U.S. and all over the world. Thank you. All right. Finished. Shut it off. Thank you. Hope I did well, Carol.